Hello, good morning and welcome. It's the 9th, Wednesday the 9th of August, and it's just after 8 o'clock. And we're going to start with the AUD JPY. This has moved nicely down for us. I'm just going to put a trend line on the RSI here. We've gone below the 50. We had a big candle down yesterday. It's retraced a little bit, and it's come back up sort of resistance-y support. So I've actually put another trade in, and I'm going to put another stop on this one here, move some of the stops down. this looks like a really good trade. I've put a trend line on the RSI. We've come down, as I said, sharply below the 50. This might stall a little bit here, maybe. We'll see how much strength it's got left in it. We're 10 to 1 short on the commitment of traders. The commitment of traders is a report that's out every week, and it shows the positions of the commercials and the speculators in America and where they're placing their money. And I get it plotted on a graph, and you actually get a chart. And this gives us an indication of where to put our money. So we're short 10.4 to 1. This is a really good short on this trade. Pound, New Zealand dollar. I put a trade in yesterday. We've gone nicely up. I can put a stop behind it. I think this is going to continue. Not particularly troubled about it. We're above the 50 on the RSI, which is nice. I'll stick another trend line in there. Love my trend lines. Here we go, stick one up there about like that. So yeah, this should go up nicely for us. Euro, British pound. The brown line is a monthly turning point, which obviously gives it a lot of strength, or more strength than say weekly or daily turning points. We popped up yesterday above it. I should have put a trade in and I didn't, but this looks a really good short down here. We have a divergence on the commitment of traders of 2.92, virtually 3 to 1 short this pair. We have just crossed the trend line on the RSI. I think I'll probably go and put a little trade in there later on. So we'll see what happens with that anyway. It's getting to a quite interesting stage. It just about hit the 69.1 on the RSI. I would have liked it to have gone up and then curved back down. It would have been a bit more powerful, but it's not bad where it is. The USD Mexican peso. The commercials have a long ratio of 2.7 to 1 for this pair. And that is fairly extreme for them. For the Mexican peso, because they've actually been short for a long, long time, short the pair. So they've actually switched positions. This has come up nicely off this resistance at the bottom. We're up now to another resistance. We've been struggling to get over it, but I think this is going to give over the next couple of days. And my target's up here at nearly 20. USD, JPY, I expected a bounce back to the mid Bollinger Band. It didn't really do it. We had this, 2 days ago, we had a little candle here, and we've promptly moved back down. We're back onto support. This has been support for the last week or so. we'll see how this goes here, but it should really follow through, all things being equal. There is a short ratio of 3.3 to 1, which was reduced. So that probably gives way for this little bounce that we've had. But I'll leave it a couple of days, see if I want to get back in. A lot of good trades out there, you know. The US dollar, Canadian dollar. I got two trades in down here, both in profit. We're up at the moment on a little bit of resistance. I don't know if you can see that just across these two candles here. It's It's pushing hard. We'll see where it goes. We're just coming up to the 50 on the RSI. I would like to get above that. Where we are at the moment, unless it dives back down, it is actually just sideways action. So maybe a little bit of sideways action across here before we break up. But I would have expected a bit better than that, being honest. New Zealand dollar, US dollar, another lovely red candle here. Very pleased with this. We're coming down to my entry point. Be pleased to see that. We're just coming down onto a bit of support here, across there. The monthly support direction change line is here. So that's really where it topped out. And that is historic. If you go back, you'll see that that's historic. The commercial short ratio is 6.7 to 1, which is fairly extreme for this pair. So we're below the 50 on the RSI. We've had divergence. It's coming down nicely. We expect it to follow through. As I say, it's coming down onto a little bit of support here. We'll see. It might be a bit choppy across for the next 3 or 4 trading days. We'll see how it goes. But if it comes down through that, it's got pretty well a clear run straight down then. Okay, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully, see you again tomorrow.